Hey folks, CA Rachana Ranade here, and I welcome you all to an IPO summary video of Premier Energies Limited. Well, this is a company which has gotten a great buzz because this company got a 2x subscription on day one itself. As I mentioned just now, it's a shoot and release video, so just in case if I fumble upon something, please check out the pinned comment. Also, I try an honest effort to summarize somewhere around 500 or 600 pager RHPs into 10 to 12 minutes videos. So if you want to stay updated with your knowledge, then please consider subscribing to my channel and also hitting the bell icon. Right now, with this, let's get started with some very basic points about this company. We have to understand what does the company do. This company was established back in 1995, and it is mainly into manufacturing of what? Of solar cells and solar modules. Okay, now first and foremost, we have to understand what is the difference between a solar cell and a solar module. So for that, I'm just going to show you one image. This is not a part of their RHP, but just thought that I should include this image so that you get a very simple clarity on the difference between a solar cell and a solar module. So if you see here, this is just one cell, okay, and this is a whole module. This is just one single cell. Similarly, a bigger version of the module is a panel, and I'm sure everyone knows about or has seen solar panels. Okay, so one a very small unit of that is a solar cell. So does this company manufacture panels and arrays? Answer is no. But yes, does the company manufacture cells and modules? Answer is yes. Okay, so one more point, this single photovoltaic cell, PV cell or PV device, is known as a cell, and these cells are connected together in chains to form larger units known as modules or panels, and that's exactly what I showed you with the help of this image. Right now that you know what does the company do, we have to understand the positioning of that company as well. As far as solar cell manufacturing is concerned, it is the second largest in India. As far as solar modules manufacturing is concerned, they are the fourth largest in India, and they have a 12 years of experience in solar EPC. So EPC is basically engineering, procurement and construction. What is this? So just in case, if let us say there is a company who wants to have a large solar module, okay, but they don't know that whether this is the right placement for that or not, how much capacity will be required, all the technical details, they are not aware about that. So what they will do, they'll come to this company, Premier Energies. Right now, Premier Energies will deploy a team. They'll have their own engineers who will do the basic engineering, the drawing, understanding the requirements, this, that. Then they'll procure the required material and then they'll construct it for them. That is nothing but EPC, engineering, procurement and construction. Right, as of 30th June 2024, as per their RHP, their key customers include companies like NTPC, Tata Power Solar Systems Limited, Panasonic Life Solutions Private Limited. I'm sure everyone has heard about these names, right? Now, talking again about the positioning, I said they are second largest in the solar cell, and as far as the solar module is concerned, they are the fourth largest. But then who come up in the first, second position? So for that, if you have a look at this, Mundra Solar, of course, this is not a listed company, but this is capturing 50% of the market share. And if you see here, Premier Energies stands at 25%. Okay, this is about solar cell. Now, if I'm talking about solar module, you can see here, first one is Wari Energies with 17% share. Second one is Renew Power with 9% share, Tata Power Solar with 7% share. And here you can see Premier Energies with 6% market share. Okay, so I think they have a fair enough chance to go to number two also if they keep on increasing the capacity that they have. But you have to understand that their capacity totally depends on how much is the industry demanding. Okay, if there is no demand, why on earth will they build up capacity? So first and foremost, very important point we have to understand is what is the industry overview? Is there more and more demand for power or not? And for that, if you have a look at this chart, you will see about installed power generation capacity in gigawatt terms. Now, from 2015 to 2030, it is growing, no doubts on that. But have a look at the trajectory after that. 2030 estimate, 2035, 40, 50, 45, 50. So from 2015 to 2050 estimated, the overall installed power generation capacity is expected to go up from 6,460 gigawatts to 33,000 plus gigawatt. Now, the more interesting part that comes up here is the share of renewable global energy generation. Why is this important right now? Because this company is into solar cells and solar modules. So for that, we have to understand how much out of the total power generation, how much is going to be the share of renewables. And if you see here, in 2015, it was around 23%. We are close to 2025. It is expected to go up to 32%. And as we go ahead in years, it is expected that it goes up to 72%. And I think if this happens, then definitely any company which is operating in this area of renewables has a fair enough chance of growth because the industry has strong tailwinds. Okay, and everyone also knows that government is also definitely giving a big push to this renewable sector. Now we are going to understand about the order book as well. But before I move on to order book, one or two quick more points. Anyone who wants to apply for any of the IPO, you have to have a DMAT account, and I'm going to put the link of account opening in the description box. You can also check that out. Also, I'm going to, just in case if you have not checked out our courses, we have courses right from beginner levels to intermediate levels and also to advanced level courses. You can definitely check out our website, rachanaranade.com. You can use the special coupon code IPO, initial public offer IPO, and this code is going to remain valid only till this month end. So hurry up and use this code so that you can get some additional discounts. Okay. Now coming back to our discussion, order book split. If you can see here, whatever total order book they have, I'll tell you the number also. The total order book currently stands at 59,265 million rupees. Okay. So how much is that? 5,926 crore rupees. Now out of this, if you see here, majority is dominated by solar modules. Why? Because solar modules, first and second put together, it's going to account for almost 38,000 million rupees. Second one, solar cells, is 18,000 million rupees, and EPC projects is barely 2,000 million rupees. Okay, so 200 crore rupees roughly. Now, out of this 5,926 crore rupees of order book, what is the split? How much orders are they receiving from private? How much are they going to receive? How much are they expected to get from public? Here, if you see, PSU and government entities accounts for 25% of the order book, and private entities account for just 75% of the order book, and PSU and government order for 25% of the order book. Now, let's talk about some very interesting parameters. Before we move on to financing parameters, today we are going to talk also about operating parameters. All these are given in their RHP again. So, if you see our order book, we have to understand increasing order book is a good sign. Obviously, they have more and more orders in hand. Number two, we have to also understand that whenever we are talking about increasing installed capacity, definitely that is also a good sign. Why? More capacity they have, more manufacturing they'll be able to do. More manufacturing is equal to more possibility of sales, is equal to more possibility of profits. Okay, simple logic. And number three, if you see that the capacity utilization is at higher levels, say it has already crossed 80% level as an example, you have to also check what are the plans of the company to further expand their installed capacity. Because obviously the moment they are going beyond 90, they need to check that they are increasing their capacity or not. Obviously, they can't go beyond 100%. So, they have to ensure that they are building up more and more capacities in advance itself. So, with this as a basic understanding, let's quickly check about their order book. You can see our order book has rapidly increased from 3,000 million to 54,000 million as at Q1 FY25. You can see that the order book stands at 5,778.79 crores roughly. Okay. Now, even if you see about the installed capacity about solar cell, of course, you will also see here it is continuously increasing from 0.5 to almost 2. Again, as at 3 months ended also is at 2. This is, of course, 2 gigawatts. Okay. Now, even if you talk about solar modules, of course, we are not going into each and every small finer details, right? But from 1.22 to 4.13 gigawatts. And if you talk about capacity utilization now, capacity utilization, which was just at around 26%, currently stands at 81% capacity utilization. So, if you see here, if their installed capacity is increasing, if their capacity utilization is increasing, even their actual production is also given. If you can see here, actual production solar cell, that has gone up from 0.11 gigawatts to 0.34 gigawatts. And even for solar module, it has gone up from 0.3 gigawatts to 0.51 gigawatts. See, ideally, if their production is increasing, ideally, we should see that reflection even in sales and even in profitability. Okay, let's see that in the financial numbers. And if you see here about revenue from operations, the revenue from operations has gone up from from 7,428 million, so roughly 742 crores to what, 3,143 crore rupees. So it's a revenue CAGR of 105%. I've already calculated it in advance. But of course, if you see here, EBITDA CAGR, it's a good one. The EBITDA CAGR is around 206%. But this is very big because the base itself is small. It's a 53 crores ka EBITDA. From 53 crore, they have gone up to 505 crores ka EBITDA. And if you see 3 months ended data, from 505 crore, they have jumped to 369 crores. So, this is just Q1 and this is the whole year. So seems very interesting. Okay, if you check out the EBITDA margin, which was around 7%, and now at 15% as at FY 2024 year ending. You can see here in June ending, it's 22%. But anyways, if you see PAT margin, they were in losses in 2022. In 23, they were again in losses. But in 24, they have come up in profit. Even same, you can see in the first quarter of FY 25, they have gone up to a profit margin of 11.87%. So all in all, ROC also, ROE, ROC, Q1 numbers look pretty much good enough, right? Now, going to the listed peer comparison, they have only one listed peer, which is Vepsol Energy Systems Limited. But the problem is that they still are in losses and this company is into profits. Okay, latest data ke hisab se. So you can definitely check out the price of Vepsol also. Check out their technical analysis chart. You will see something interesting in their chart also. Now, talking about unlisted peers. Unlisted peers mein, what I have done is for Premier Energies. Now, see again, the problem is that for PAT, we have few in negatives also, right? Here, 1, 2, 3 in negatives. So, rather than comparing that, what we have done is that we have taken an average of EBITDA of all these companies, all these unlisted average EBITDA margins, and this comes up to 7.82%, and this company's EBITDA margin is 7.7%. So more or less similar as compared to its unlisted peers. Talking about risks now, one important risk that I could see in their RHP is that whatever they import from China, the cost of imported material from China, that accounts for 46.9% of their total purchases. So obviously, if government says that there's going to be some import restriction from China, if they increase the import duty on products which are being imported from China, this is going to get impacted, no doubts on that. And also, so this is a big chunk. Cost of imported materials from other countries is barely 17%. Talking about one more risk, which is pending litigations, you have to see typically these three columns against the company, against their directors and against their subsidiaries. But all put together, it's coming to around 5.92% of PAT. What I typically check, personally I check, is that is it beyond 10% of their PAT or not? In that case only, I'll be a little bit more cautious about it. Anything less than 10% of 1 year PAT. Okay. Now, a question is what are they going to do with this money? But for that, I'm first going to go to the IPO detail point. Here you can see that fresh issue is 1291 crores and offer for sale is 1539 crores. Question is, what are they going to do with this money of 1291 crores? For that, we are again now going back to the objects of the issue. This is going to be used for what? For capacity enhancement. So they are going to add up capacity. They are going to increase the capacity in one of their subsidiary companies, which is Premier Energies Global Environment Private Limited. Okay. And they are going to establish a 4 gigawatt solar PV TOPCon cell and a 4 gigawatt solar PV TOPCon module manufacturing facility in Hyderabad, Telangana. In simple words, they are going to use this money to set up plants, two plants, one for solar cell and one for solar module, where in Hyderabad, Telangana, and second one is general corporate purposes. The IPO date is from 27th of August to 29th August, so IPO closes tomorrow. Price band is 427 to 450. That's the minimum application size for you and basic details. So I hope with this you have understood that what does the company do. You have understood about the industry analysis as well. You have understood that the biggest point for this company is the overall industry tailwinds, the overall power generation, and that too, if I'm talking about renewable sources of energy, that is going to get a good push. So all in all, what do you think about this IPO? Let me know in the comment section, and I'll come up with more and more such IPO summaries for you if you like it. So if you have liked this, please consider smashing the like button. I'll see you in the next one. Till then, take care. Jai Hind and bye bye.